Have you ever worked with an insecure teammate or leader? Here's what I mean by insecure. They try to make themselves indispensable. They don't want to train or empower other people to reach their potential or be more successful than they are. As a matter of fact, they don't want anyone to succeed without their help. And anytime someone does rise to a higher level, they see it as a threat. Now, I get it. It's frustrating, but there is a solution. In the book of 1 Samuel, there's a story of two men, King Saul and David. Saul has promoted David to the commander of his army. He is proud of David's success. David has killed the giant Goliath, after all. But things quickly change when the women come out dancing and singing and praising Saul for killing only thousands, but David for killing 10,000s. Saul becomes enraged. What's this? They credit David with 10,000s and me with only thousands? Next, they'll be making him their king, he says. And so the Bible says, Saul kept a jealous eye on David from that moment going forward. Here's why. The women tapped into Saul's insecurity, an insecurity that kept growing the more David succeeded. The more Saul felt that the Lord was with David, the more insecure Saul became. Saul had two choices. He could see David's leadership ability as a blessing and help develop it, or he could see it as a threat and try everything in his power to keep David from rising to the throne. He could see David as someone who could carry on his legacy, or he could see David as a threat to his legacy. He chose the latter in both cases. David spent years on the run because of Saul's insecurity. But in the end, God's plan for David's life didn't change, and eventually God replaced Saul with David as king. If you're dealing with an insecure person, here are three steps you can take. First, be encouraged. God's plan and promise for you will still happen no matter what they try to do to keep you from moving ahead. Second, pray for them. Most likely their insecurity runs deeper than you know, perhaps even to their childhood. Pray for those things too. Third, the Bible says, don't repay their evil with evil, but with good. You can do that by finding ways to help them build their confidence. Now, if you're watching this and you've realized that you struggle with insecurity, here's what you can do. Become more intentional about helping others develop and be more successful, and do it without thinking about how it will benefit you. Finally, train others to reach their potential, knowing they aren't a threat to your legacy. They could actually be a blessing to it.